auspicious and delightful evening to one and all present here. It's a very great honor for me to be the leader of Team Lucifer. So, I, Yogita, is here for a group discussion on the topic social networking sites. So, let me first introduce my team members.
Hi guys, I'm Pete Tilwal.
Hi guys, I'm Dipanshu.
Hi guys, I'm Chitra.
As we all are familiar with the use of social networking sites in our daily life, so to keep my views on it, I would like to say, nowadays we can see youngsters are hooked on social networking sites and they don't like to mingle with their family members and even they ignore their studies too. They should not do that. Study is very important. So guys, you think, how can youngsters give more time to social networking sites whole the day? Didn't they get bored? Even if I will use social networking sites by whole the day, I will get bored, then why didn't they? So, I would like to call Kirti and ask her a question, that why are youngsters hooked on social networking sites?
First of all, thanks to my group leader, Ms. Yogita, for giving me the golden opportunity so that I can share my views regarding this problem. Social media. Social media is a way for teenagers to stay in touch with their friends. Teenagers have always talk after school long before social media, hanging out at the bus stop, at the local park, chatting on the phone. Now, they just have a different platform to do so. It is an important part of socializing and connection in the modern world. Teenagers and social media use in increasing. The main reason is teenagers regularly use social media include like talking with friends, meeting new people, etc. That's why youngsters continuously hooked on social media. Thank you.
Well, thanks, Kirti. Guys, you are very well aware that if there is anything, it has both its positive and negative effects in our lives. So, let us know about the positive and negative effects of social media on our daily life. So, I would like to call Dipanshu.
Hello everyone. First of all, thanks to my group leader, Ms. Yogita, for inviting me here. So friends, staying connected, making new friends and reading news are all great aspects of social media. But as a coin has two faces, so its dark side includes cyberbullying, which is a crime. Nowadays, the fake news get viral easily. Moreover, it directly affects the life of a student by lowering their grades, causing problems such as weakening of eyesight and lack of concentration power and many more. But it is a best platform for launching something new or a best place for start a program. This concludes that social networking site have both positive and negative aspects in our life. Thank you.
So guys, you know what is most important in our life, without which we cannot achieve our goals? So, of course guys, it's a study. Without study, we cannot achieve our goals. So, I would like to call Sumitra ma'am and ask her a question, that how can youngsters ignore their studies only for social networking sites?
Hello everyone. First of all, I would like to thanks to my group leader Yogita to giving me a chance to share my views regarding this problem. As we know, the youngsters always hook on social networking sites. In beginning, they use social networking sites only for their study material. But after sometimes they forget why they are use internet. They spend whole time on searching pictures, games, etc. And sometimes they are not able to deliver their work at their specified time frame. Popularity of social networking sites, the youth to distract themselves their studies. So we should seriously think about this problem. Thank you.
So now, guys, you think, that youngsters are hooked on social networking sites through their smartphones. But who provide them smartphones? Their parents provide them smartphones. But not for their, that they will use social networking sites and they will use WhatsApp, Facebook, Insta and so on. They provide them smartphones for their better future. They think that their children will use them for educational purpose. But their thinking is absolutely wrong. They think that, but youngsters, they are misusing their thinking. They are misusing their smartphones. So, I'm here and now I will tell you that how are parents responsible for for this problem. So, you know that parents think that whatever their children demand them, they should complete their demand. They should, if a children ask him or her parents that please provide me a smartphone, then parents also think that he might be asking for his educational purpose, but it is not so. He wanted for chatting, for Facebook, Insta, using WhatsApp and all that. But parents are responsible for that they should not provide their smartphones, or they should take care that whatever their children is using in the smartphone. Now, as you know, if there is any problem, there must be a solution of that. So, now I will tell you that how can we solve this problem. It's true that youngsters are hooked on social networking sites and they neglect their studies and even they refuse to mingle with their family members. To encourage youngsters, elders should give them small tasks every day so that they can be be busy. And when task is completed, they should even get more fun encouraging task in which their mind is likely to get enjoyed. After the task, there should be a minimum limit of time limit of 2 hours for studying. And they should even get small reward like anything their favorite, whatever they want, in a manner to appreciate them, and should even get a maximum time for 30 minutes for using social networking sites, but not more than that. They will be hooked on them. So that's all for today. Thank you.